And one of the scribes came up and heard them disputing with one another, and seeing that he answered them well, questioned him, "Which commandment is the first of all?" Jesus answered, "The first is, 'Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one, and you shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, and with all your strength. The second is this, you shall love your neighbor as yourself. There is no other commandment greater than this." Good morning. Welcome to a short biblical reflection on the reading from the Gospel according to Mark chapter 12, verses 28 up to 34. The same or similar situation is described also in other synoptic Gospels, Matthew chapter 22 and Luke chapter 10. But before going to the synoptic comparison, let's see more closely our reading in the Gospel according to Mark. The opening of the story refers to the preceding one, in which the Sadducees, who do not believe in the resurrection, came up to Jesus questioning him about the resurrection. Now is one of the scribes which questions Jesus concerning the commandments. Which commandment is the first of all? We can understand this question in the sense of order, which of the commandments is the first in order or in priority, in importance. Knowing that according to Jewish tradition recorded in the Talmud, in the Torah, it means in the books of law, the first five books of the Old Testament, there are 613 different commandments, 248 positive and 365 negative. Since there is this multitude of different commandments, therefore this question rather regards the priority of importance. Jesus answers the scribe quoting from two different books of the Old Testament. The first part concerning God, Jesus quotes from the book of Deuteronomy chapter 6 verses 4 up to 5, and the one concerning love of neighbor is quoted from the book of Leviticus chapter 19 verse 18. Because in the Old Testament, those two commandments, or as we call them also, one commandment, they are not put together, but they are put together in the Gospels. Then the scribe answers, and in the first part of his answer, "Well, teacher, you have truly said that he is one and there is no other but he quotes from the book of Deuteronomy chapter 4 verse 35. In the second part of his answer, when he states that loving God means more than the sacrifices, we can refer to other biblical texts, for example, the first book of Solomon, chapter 15, verse 22, and Hosea, chapter 6, verse 6. In the last verse, 34, Mark comments the situation, and when Jesus saw that he answered wisely, he said to him, "You are not far from the kingdom of God." And after that, no one dared to question him anymore. So at the beginning, we have the scribe question Jesus. Then there is the statement that nobody else dared to question Jesus anymore. But important is also the quotation which Mark puts here. "You are not far from the kingdom of God." This statement of Jesus can recall the beginning of the Gospel in chapter 1, verse 15, when Jesus begins his mission. He says, "The time has come. The kingdom of God has come near. Repent and believe in the gospel." So we can say that this scribe has come near with his reasoning to the understanding of the kingdom. But now what is needed? What Jesus says, repent and believe in the gospel. He also has to take this step. Now let us see briefly this text in a synoptic comparison. Beginning with the story as it is recorded in Luke chapter 10, that has completely different setting. There is a certain lawyer which is coming to Jesus with a question what he shall do to inherit eternal life. And therefore, Jesus answered him, stating this commandment, putting this commandment together as one. And then the reaction of this lawyer, which wanted to justify him, therefore, immediately after that follows this famous parable about the Good Samaritan. But the story, as it is recorded in the Gospel according to Matthew chapter 22, is more similar. However, it is much shorter. It is just half of what Mark states. In particular, they are missing the important last lines which we have in the Gospel according to Mark. But the setting of those two stories in Mark and Matthew is similar because it's preceding by the same story when the Sadducees are coming to Jesus, questioning him about the resurrection. Other elements which differentiate those two stories in Matthew and Mark are the following. In Matthew is a lawyer, similarly to what states Luke, a certain lawyer, while in Mark we have one of the scribes. And the question formulated in Matthew and Mark is a little bit different. In Mark is the question, the first of all commandments, why in Matthew is the greatest of the commandments in the law. After this synoptic comparison, I can make a few remarks that such synoptic comparison is helpful to certain extent. It can clarify if we do not have a clear picture who is asking whom, what was exactly the question, what were the circumstances. But on the other hand, in particular, the striking shortness of Matthew's description, why his gospel is much longer than the Markan gospel, and also those who use the hypothesis of the priority of Markan gospel, but then developed into the two source hypothesis of the composition of the Synoptic Gospels. According to that hypothesis, Matthew and Luke quoted extensively from Mark. He is surprising that Markan description is much longer. Matthew does not include the last part. I would like to point out that I strongly believe that each evangelist is not just a compiler who mechanically copied and pasted, if we use today's terminology, using the computer. Each of them developed the story in his own view, in his own theology. Therefore, we have to go back again and to make the last remark, looking only and exclusively at the flow of the story in the Gospel according to Mark. We could say that there are two important lines, one traced by the verb to question, the one which is already used in the preceding story when the Sadducees are coming and questioning Jesus. Now the scribe is coming and questioning Jesus. So this verb has the strength not only simply putting a question, but also testing Jesus. After the whole story, Mark states that no one dared to question him anymore. So the situation now changes radically, and also the words of Jesus, "You are not far from the kingdom of God." At the beginning of the gospel, Jesus is announcing that the kingdom of God is at hand, and convert and believe in the gospel. We could say that now this statement of Jesus from the beginning of the gospel is like presented to this scribe indirectly. He has also now to convert and to believe in the gospel, so he has to become, in other words, the disciple of Jesus, following him, listening to his words and putting them into practice. I would like to wish you a nice day, a nice reflection.